Mr. Cruel is in the papers again today. It's been 20 years since the abduction, well, sorry, since the body was found of Karmien Chan. She was the last, what they suspect, victim of Mr. Cruel. And this is where I come in. Around the time of her disappearance, I lived in Coburg, and I didn't have a car. The nearest shop to my house opened at about 8 o'clock in the morning, and I had no milk. And with a child under about 1 year of age, I had to have milk first thing in the morning. Sometimes 6:30, 7 o'clock, I had to have milk there, otherwise this kid's just going to scream. So I decided to take the walk from Elizabeth Street, Coburg, where I was living at the time, and I was going to Hendy Street and Gilbert Road. This was my destination for one of the 7-Elevens that I lived near. I lived in between two, both were at the same distance. I just happened to go this way on that night. This was the night of the Karmien Chan disappearance. This was the night she was taken. I made out about 11 o'clock at night. Don't know the exact time, but I know it was around 11 because I thought I can get to this store and back to my home within about an hour, and I can be in bed by maybe just after 12. It's about a 20 minute walk, but you know, screwing around at the store and whatnot, I didn't know what time I'd get back. On my way to the store, I cut through a creek area. Have to walk up a big hill to get to the shop, sort of just putting it off to the end of the journey. So I was looking towards the creek as I took my route along Elizabeth Street, up Jenkins, down, I don't know the name of that road there. But anyway, heading towards Henty Street and Gilbert Road. Walking along the creek, I hear a crack. It's a gunshot. I didn't hear any gunshots before this, I didn't hear any gunshots after this. And apparently Karmien Chan had 3 bullets put in the back of her head. But when I looked up, I seen a ute. Relative to that era, I seen a man standing there looking like he was wearing possibly overalls and then like a spray jacket on the top. And he had his back turned to me with the gun raised up in the air. It was almost like he seen me coming, set the gun off to let me know he was there, and, well, it was enough to frighten the shit out of me, and I took off up what I think is called Kingsley Road, which goes up to Gilbert Road, and then I walked along to Henty Street where the 7-Eleven was. Didn't think much of this until the next day, when Karmien Chan was all over the news. And it came to me that I may have seen her killer, or her abductor, abductor and killer I should say. Anyway, went out of my mind again, till a year or two later, when Karmien Chan's body turns up in Thomastown behind an electric plant. By this time I'd moved from Elizabeth Street in Coburg, and now I'm just going to flick through the blocks. Well, I moved. There's Hughes Parade, there's High Street. I ended up living on High Street, not far from Marnie's Road in Thomastown. And that's where her body was found, Thomastown Terminal Station. Which I'll just put in, make sure it's in screen there. The cops set up a caravan, and I went and told them what I'd seen on that night. anyway.